To use the MakeyMakey, you'll need one of the laptops out of the kit, fully charged, ready to go. One of the 12 red boxes that contain all of the MakeyMakey parts, and something to connect with, such as fruit and vegetables, utensils, alfoil, anything metal that will conduct electricity. The resources for the MakeyMakey are found in the staff portal. Once you log into the portal, on the left-hand side, you'll see My Learning Tools. Clicking on the Learning Tools and scrolling right to the bottom, you'll see a red T4L icon labeled STEM T4L Learning Library. This is able to be accessed from both students and teachers. Within the library, you'll find all of the resources needed to get started. Because we're looking at the Inventor Robotics kit, under the kits on the right-hand side, we'll click Inventor Robotics. As we scroll down, we will see lots of videos to help us with our learning. Under the videos, we'll find learning challenges for the kit. The Ultimate Game Controller is one of the best learning challenges for the MakeyMakey to start with. All of the learning challenges come with mini challenges as well as syllabus notes. Now, the syllabus content for this is based on stage 2. However, you could use this equipment with younger students that were working with an older buddy, such as kindergarten, with a year 6 assistant. The MakeyMakey is a fantastic tool to encourage coding, where the students create their own game in a coding platform such as Tinker or MakeCode, and then create their own game controller to operate the game. Today we'll introduce you to the MakeyMakey. In the kit, there are 12 of these invention kits found in red boxes designed to connect everyday objects as computer keys. Within the MakeyMakey kit, we find 3 main components: one circuit board, at least 7 coloured alligator clips, and one red USB cord that connects the circuit board to the computer. The circuit board is made to emulate the keyboard. On the front, there are the regular up, down, left and right arrows, a space bar and a click button. There is also a long panel across the bottom labelled Earth. This is the basic ground of the circuit and is important when connecting the whole circuit together. To expand your MakeyMakey learning, if you turn the circuit board over, you will see a gold connector at the top where you connect your lead to the computer, and this will provide the power supply. There is a main chip that communicates with the computer, and you'll also notice black rectangles on either side and across the top. These rectangles provide extra input options when connecting using plain wire. Now that we know all of the components of the MakeyMakey, let's connect them together. So we'll take the circuit board and place the end of the red USB into the gold connector. We'll take the other end of the USB port and plug it into the laptop. This will provide the power for the circuit board. And you can see that we now have lights appearing on the circuit board. Please be careful when plugging the port into the USB so that you don't accidentally plug the USB into the HDMI port on the right-hand side of the computer. The next part of connecting is using the alligator clips. The alligator clips come with plastic coating. We'll push at the end of the alligator, opening the jaws, and place one side of the jaw in one hole, the second side of the jaw into the other, so that as they come together on the underside, they make a connection to the metal. If I were to connect multiple parts to the circuit board, I could use these pieces of plain wire into the back black boxes. This would give me more places to connect to. Depending on the learning challenge, will depend on the items that you use to connect to your MakeyMakey. These items are all found either around the house or the classroom. The first one being aluminium foil. You can cut this into small squares, roll it into balls, or just use it as a flat piece. The second part is a piece of fruit. You can use bananas, apples, strawberries, any type of fruit or vegetable that contains a lot of water. Now, if this was going to be a messy fruit, I would connect my fruit with one of the single white cords first. But this banana isn't messy, so I'm going straight into the skin. You can also use items such as cutlery. Or, if your students like drawing, you can have them use a 2, 4 or 6B pencil to draw their own button. This is done on a sticky note, and we're just going to fold it in half to make a connection on both sides of the paper, and then connect the alligator clip. To make sure that we've got a ground or an earth, I've got other items smaller within the classroom, like a paper clip, or you could even use a split pin. So there are lots of different items that you can use to connect your game controller. And this isn't even the limit. If you've made Play-Doh, you could use Play-Doh. Or if you've got other objects lying around, have fun creating. Some troubleshooting methods when using the MakeyMakey. When placing the MakeyMakey down on the desk, try not to put too much pressure in the downward direction, as it can damage these ports on the back. The second part that you need to watch is a common problem with the alligator wires. The alligator clips can come with the insulation pulled all the way back. When this happens and the alligator clips are connected together, the 3 or 4 within the arrow section can touch each other and form a short circuit. To make sure that this doesn't happen, just press on the alligator clip in a partially open form and push the insulation back on. This protects your circuit. The last item is the earth. You'll notice there are 6 earth ports. You don't need to connect into all 6, just one port needs to be connected. Now, the person that is going to be playing the objects connected to the other leads needs to make sure that they are touching the metal alligator clip that is attached to the earth. This will complete the circuit, and then you'll have the ability to play all of your items.
This video is part of a series of support videos all about the kit that you have borrowed. To find the other videos in this series, head to the Learning Library and visit the kit page for the equipment you've borrowed. You can also find the full list of support videos for all of our kit on the YouTube channel. You can also join us in the Yammer community. If you have any questions or you'd like to ask teachers how they've used the equipment in their classroom, then why not join us on the STEM T4L Facebook community? It's a closed group. You can ask teachers how they've used the equipment and also share the work samples that your students have created.